Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this particular video, I'm going to show you how to use multiple phone cameras on vMix, and you can even use up to four phones. Can you imagine? You can use up to four phones as your main video source on vMix. One can be picking from this angle, as you can see right there, and another one can also be facing you, as you can also see right here, which is what I'm going to show you in this particular video. I've also made a couple of these videos in the past. One was using camera FI Live, and the other one was using New Tech NDI, which I got lots of complaints regarding the camera FI Live, because you have to use the vMix SRT method before you can be able to bring in your phone camera on vMix. Okay, so some complain that the camera FI Live is outdated and it's no longer working. The New Tech NDI tutorial that I shared, I also got complaint regarding that it's not working perfectly fine and it's lagging. But in this video, I'm going to show you one that is the perfect method, where you can also use your USB and use your Wi-Fi connection, depending on whichever one you want to make use of, and you are in charge of the video resolution you select. So even if your video your phone camera has a lower resolution, you can also choose higher resolution for it, and you can select up to 4K resolution to be used as your video source on vMix. Okay, and also bring it in on vMix along with the video and audio working perfectly fine. So if you cannot use Wi-Fi, you can also make use of USB, and this app is 100% free. Okay, so you don't get to pay a huge amount of money to be able to make use of this particular program. Okay, so without any further ado, let me take you through this particular tutorial. In case you haven't subscribed to this YouTube channel, consider subscribing. Just hit that red subscribe button below and turn on the notification bell, so you'll always be notified whenever I upload new videos. And if you're a returning subscriber and you love what we are doing in this my YouTube channel, kindly give this video a thumbs up, so the YouTube algorithm can also recommend it to other people as well, so they can see the content we are sharing, and we'll have lots and lots of updates coming up on this my YouTube channel. So let me quickly show you how everything is done. So as you can see right there, I have my two phones there. One is this, and then the other one is this. So I'm just going to take them off all, and let's go straight from the scratch. Okay, so I'm just going to take this off and close this vMix. Okay, so that is it. Close the vMix, and then close this one too. Now, the software we'll be making use of is called Irium Webcam. You can see it here, Irium Webcam. Sorry if I don't pronounce the name right. It's called Irium Webcam. That is the software we're going to be making use of, and you can even bring in up to four cameras on this Irium Webcam. Okay, so let me show you how to set it up on your system before we go over to app, and also show you how to get it free of charge and set up your app, the Irium Webcam app. Okay, so, and also use your USB connection or Wi-Fi, whichever one you want to make use of. So I'm just going to close this, all of this, and with this close, go over to your browser and type in here on your browser, Joe, whichever one you're making use of, type in Irium Webcam. Okay, so this is it here, Irium Webcam. Just click on it, and one of the most amazing thing about this app is you can also use it for your Windows, your Mac, and your Ubuntu. So even if you're using an iPhone, you can also download it from your app store, okay, and also use it along with your Mac. That's if you're using Mac, or if you're using Windows, you can also still make use of it like that. Okay, so I'm just going to download the version for Windows, which is the one I'm making use of. So I'm just going to click on that and then wait for it to download. And once it has finished downloading, just open the folder where you downloaded it. Just go over to our download folder, and you can see it right here. You can see it here, Irium Webcam 2.7.2. And then click on see run as an administrator there. So once your mouse is on it, just right click and you see the run as administrator there. So just select the run as administrator, and down here you see the number of cameras here. This is where you select the number of cameras you want to make use of on vMix, number of phone you want to make use of on vMix. So if you want to use 4, 3 phones, or whichever number of phones you want to make use of, that is where you are going to select it. But I advise you select 4, because you might want to add more phones in the future as your video source on vMix. So just select 4. That's it. Click on accept, and next, and that will install the Irium Webcam has been successfully installed. So I'm just going to click on finish, and you will see it right here. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is to also show you how to install the mobile app and get it free of charge, okay? What you're going to do is to go over to your Play Store and then go over to Play Store right here. Go over to Play Store and search for Aeron webcam. You can see it, a 4K webcam for PC and Mac. And once you've searched for it, install it on your phone. Now, if you want to purchase the premium version, which is just click on open. Let's open it first. If you want to purchase the premium version, you can see how everything is looking. If you want to purchase the premium version, just click on this certain sign here, and you see I already bought that. It costs about $4, which is little to compare to what you'll be using this app for. So I urge you, if you want to see the advanced features like those other tabs down here, you can also purchase the premium version of the app, and also to get rid of the watermark, which appears at the top here, somewhere at the top, and it's not visible at all. Nobody sees that, and nobody's going to see it. So if you want to purchase it, all you have to do is to also pay the $4 and get the premium version of this particular app, okay? So if you don't want, you can also use it free of charge. It's 100% free, and there's no ads on it, so you won't have to see any ads at all disturbing you while making use of this app. And one of the beautiful things I also love about it is it works in the background too. So even if you minimize your phone, you're doing any other thing on it, or you're searching for something, the Aeron webcam will still be showing. So it adapts to that on Android and also on iPhone also, which is, the video is also coming up sooner or later. I'm also going to make a video on iPhone version of it as well, okay? So that is it. And if you want to make use of your USB, currently you can see right here, if you want to make use of your USB, as you can see, this is my USB there. If you want to make use of your USB, as you can see right there, if you want to make use of your USB, all you have to do is to plug in your USB, whether type C, Android, iPhone, whichever one you're making use of, and then plug it into your phone and also to your PC. Now, after you've plugged in that, go over to your phone settings here. Let me just show you that. Go over to your phone settings here, scroll down, go to about phones and software information, click the build number 4 times and the developer mode will be unlocked for you. So I'm currently using Samsung, that is why I can see this option from here. So if you're using any other phone, it's still the same process you go through. Just click on the build number 4 times and you unlock the developer option, as you can see here, which is the developer mode. So click on the developer mode, scroll down, and you see the USB debugging option here. You can see this is it here. So turn that on to be able to use your Android and connect it on Aeron webcam and also on your PC as well, okay? So once this is turned on, go ahead and open the app, okay? So go ahead and open the app, and that is it right here, okay? So go ahead and open the app. You can see currently I've not opened the software on my PC, which is why it's showing this stuff on my screen. So let me go ahead and open it. And before you do anything, do make sure your phone and your PC is connected to the same network. See, this is my external internet here. This is the external one I'm currently making use of. So make sure that your phone and your PC are connected to the same network. Now, if you are not using USB, make sure they are connected to the same network. But if you are using USB, you don't have to worry about connecting all of them to the same network. But the USB is when you are not moving your phone, okay? So when your phone is in one place. But if you have to move the phone around the congregation, try to video every action that is happening in the congregation, you have to use a very strong internet and connect all of them to it, which is like this one you are seeing right here. It's my external internet, and all the phones, like the two of them I'm using, is also connected to it. See, it's connected to it. Let's make use of the USB connection, okay? So I'm just going to double click on it and wait for it to load. You can see, so let's see, you can see this one, you can see USB Samsung SM-A51-5F, you can see USB. So this one is making use of USB, while the second one is making use of Wi-Fi, as you can see right here. Let me just enlarge this, you can see USB. So this one is making use of USB, while the second one is make use of Wi-Fi, which is not really giving us what we want, but at least the camera of the first one, which is the Samsung, is actually better than that of the Tecno Camon 12. Okay, so that is it. Let me hang on this phone, and that is it right there. I see. So this is the USB, and also you can set your resolution higher or lower depending on whichever one you want to make use of. So if you want to use 4K, see, just click on this three dots there and see the video format as auto. You can set it on 4K, which is this one. You can set it on full HD. I'm just going to set it on 4K, and you can see how it looks like. You can see the 4K quality of it. You can see how it looks like. And also go to your camera too. You can also set the resolution of this one. Set it also on 4K, and you can see how it looks like. See, it's better now. See? So if you leave it as automatic or automatic, it's going to make use of your phone camera resolution. But if you set it on 4K, it's going to improve the quality of your phone camera. You can see that's it right here. You can see how it's looking sharp and everything is working perfectly fine. So there's no lag, which is also one of the things I love about this app. There's no lag at all. It sync in perfectly fine. So whatever thing you're seeing, everything is going really well. Now if you also want to enjoy it, I would advise you use an external mic for it. Okay, so let me show you how to connect the if you're using your phone as your mic, let me show you how to connect it. And if you're also using an external mic, let me show you how to also connect that as well. Okay, so let's open our vMix. Okay, so you can see, so this is our vMix. Our vMix is up and running already. Now go over to add input here, and then select camera, then go over here, and you can see the room webcam there. Select that and choose your resolution. You can choose 4K, which I'm going to choose right now. So I just selected 4K because I already selected 4K on the room webcam. Okay, so select 4K, and if you want to use your external mic, this is my external mic plugged in, you can also select that. If you want to use the external mic, that's the external mic I plugged into my system, you can also select that and click on OK. You can see, and everything will sync in perfectly fine. You can see, so this one is USB, and you can see this is USB, and it's working perfectly fine. Now also for the one I used the Wi-Fi on, so let's also bring that particular one in too. So click on the add input camera, select this, and then select the second one, which is our second camera. Let's also select 4K. So because I put it on 4K, that's why it seems a bit lagging. You can see, because I set everything on 4K. So on the audio device, select none, just select none, don't worry, and click on OK. So I'm currently using 4K, that's why it's lagging. You can see, so it's currently lagging because even my phone is not up to 4K. It's currently full HD, but I increase the quality from the Arium webcam. So you can see just this three dot line there. You can see here the video format there. So I selected 4K, which is why it's lagging. So I understand. Okay, so you can see the phone on right there. I also set it on 4K too, which is why it's also lagging as well. So for us to bring in our audio for the phone, remember the first one if you're using an external audio. Now for the second one, if you're not using an external audio, let's go to the add input again and go over to audio input. See audio input, click on it, add, and you see the microphone Arium webcam 2, which is my second phone mic. So I'm just going to bring that in here, and you can see. So this one is if you're using a mic for it, and this one is if you have your mic plugged into your phone. Okay, or if you're using your phone mic, whichever one you're making use of. So that is it for here, and this is it. I see everything is on 4K. Sorry, that's why it's lagging like this. So everything is on 4K. Even the second phone that I'm using is not up to 4K. I think it should be about 720. Yeah, 720, but I changed it for 4K. So that's why everything is looking like this. You see? So this is it. So in case you love videos like this, just give this video a thumbs up and also subscribe to my YouTube channel. We are hoping to get to 3,000 family members here on YouTube. and we're currently at 2,800, just 200 more to go. So thank you all for those of you that subscribe. Also subscribe to this YouTube channel for more updates and also more tricks and more tutorials like this. Okay.